So this video is going to inform you of how a turbocharger works and the components needed for a turbocharger system. So here's what happens. Now, we know in our engine cycle that at the end we're going to force out exhaust gases. So these exhaust gases are fed out through some piping into this turbine called the turbocharger. What happens here is these exhaust gases spin the turbine, and this turbine is connected by a shaft, we can represent that right here, connected to another turbine, which is sucking in outside air as it spins. This outside air is forced in, and it's going to be pressurized now. So it's not just atmospheric pressure that you're putting into the engine, you're forcing in more air, so we call that boost. So this air is forced in. Now what happens when you're forcing in a greater amount of air is when you add pressure, you also add heat, and you don't want to add already hot air into the engine. So you're going to pass this air through an intercooler. Now this is just a bunch of coils. Some of them use a liquid system, but most are just air-based, and it'll pass through some coils and that'll cool down the air. This cool air then travels through some the intake manifold, and that will come in to your engine chamber. Now, there's some things that people have added in to make this more feasible. So we've got two things here now. We've got a blow-off valve and we've got a wastegate. Now, when you've got exhaust gases coming through and you don't want to reach, say, 8 psi, so you set a limit on your wastegate at 8 psi, and what happens when this turbine spinning here realizes that the air it's sucking in is going to be forced in at 8 psi, it'll open up this wastegate. This wastegate will allow the air that's going into the exhaust turbine to feed out through the exhaust instead of creating more boost. So that helps on this side. Now, on the other hand, every time you let go of the ignition, you're going to have boost inside of this intake manifold that you can't use. So what happens is you'll shut off the throttle, this intake valve will close, and you've got all this pressurized air that's wanting to go into this cylinder. So because it's got nowhere to go, you can have a blow-off valve which will let that air escape. Now, how this works is once you get to the PSI that you set at, say you'll have a spring that at 6 PSI, it'll let air out. So you're revving up high in your car, you let go of the gas, and this throttle plate closes, and then all this air is being forced into here and it reaches 6 PSI. Well, this spring will lift up and let the air out, and you'll hear a hissing sound, and that's what that is when you let off the throttle plate, is this blow-off valve letting out air. So those are the main four components. You've got the turbocharger, which consists of the two turbines used to force in air. You've got the intercooler, which cools the air going into the engine. You've got a wastegate that lets exhaust gases escape if you've reached a high enough boost already. And you've got a blow-off valve for when you let go of the gas, the air has somewhere to go. And those are the four main components of a turbocharger.